Hi, I'm George Hancin. One of my favorite things to do is do outdoor plein air painting, and this is the Chestnut House. This is the Chestnut House, and I've been asked to do a painting of it. And so I've walked around it several times, checking different angles, see which appeals to me the most. And I've decided on this one because I like the interaction of the cemetery with it, and some of the foliage starting to change on the one side. And I like it being in a two-point perspective instead of too straight on. So for those reasons, I've decided on this. And so now I'm going to do a sketch. So now I'm going to do a sketch or two of it to prepare for the painting, to make sure that this is what I really want to do, and to kind of familiarize myself with the whole project. And so the sketch is supposed to be pretty quick and loose, and just I'm not crazy about the composition with the White House next to it, so I'm gonna maybe move the foliage, because there's some red foliage there, and add that to the corner of the painting. And also some of those tall, kind of wispy trees that are, since I made them a little too tall. So that might be the edge of the painting there. Like I said, this is just a quick thing to make me more comfortable about when I'm clear what I'm doing. The tricky part is going to be the little grated fence, the fence. You have the gravestones overlapping. And then there's going to be a big column. Yeah, let's see. Going to be dark tones in between with the tall tree above it. So actually, that monument is surrounded by two tall trees and a lot of dark foliage. All the smaller background, foreground tombstones.
It's amazing how fast you pulled it all together.
Well, this is supposed to be a fast sketch, so I don't lose interest when I start doing actual painting. And then I'll spend a lot more time on it. The rocks are kind of cool and interesting. right, so I'm happy enough with that for the composition. So now I gotta set up all my painting stuff and start doing the drawing and on the canvas. Or I'll spend more time on. All right, so now I am going to figure out where to place everything on the canvas so it sort of matches my practice sketch. And where's all my charcoal? So I usually do that with vine charcoal because I can erase it over and over again till I get things how I want them to be. I think that roof is too much, too big. See, the other thing I need to consider, which I don't think I did, is how much sky. There's a beautiful sky right now. So I might just want to lower everything. So if I want the stone wall to be here and the house is way, that makes the meeting house way down here. So I have it way too much, too high. See if I got this proportion well. If I get the. So I need to do some measuring. So the width to the height. So the width is. Brush is better. So the width of that part is about. So the height is almost square. Actually that's about right. Just a little taller in height than width. And so the windows are way up here. We have three windows close together and one kind of apart. And then the entranceway is exactly in the middle. And then there's one window close to the door. And then two windows on the other side. So that's about right. So this should be straight in perspective, and this should be going up in perspective. Now this should be going down in perspective. So the windows really almost touch the gutter. They're way up here. So we have two, one in the middle, and these two should be closer together because they're further away. All right, and then so that's the middle. And this should, no, it's bigger. This entrance is taller than that one. So, and again, we have two, and they like go right underneath each other. Two windows here, and two windows here, and then the chimneys up here. Got all these beautiful clouds. That's going to be fun to do. And then on this side, there's going to be these trees that I'm going to cheat and move this all over to a landscape here. And then And then we've got one monument here. And then we have this ground plane. And we've got the reddish, that nice reddish tree here. And we've got two bunches of foliage here. And so I want to do a measuring again. So yeah, that's about right. The same distance here as to where the monument is. So the monument lines up with the doorway. And it goes about to the, lines up with the middle of the roof. And then there's a little perspective ground platform here. That goes up to here. Okay. And then we have a couple of gravestones here, and some smaller ones in there. Several gravestones. Okay, now the wall actually touches this. And the wall goes here, and so that's gonna be all the bricks, I mean all the stones. And then the road's gonna kinda angle off this way. All right, well that's the basic composition. Okay, now I don't like to do too much drawing. That's enough drawing. And now it's time to paint. So now I need my palette. Another clip. Okay, so now the thing about skies, they're constantly changing. So you can kind of pretty much do what you want. You can pick any part of the sky you like the best and start with that. And I should take some photographs now too, because everything's going to change. Like the sky over here. So that's gonna be my sky. Okay. As much as possible. So I am going to, I need my medium, which is linseed oil and turpentine. Oh no, I got it out. It's right here. Mixing some cerulean blue into the white. I'm going to add some more medium to it because it's a little dry. I like to start off painting wet, thinner and wet, and then I gradually get thick. So. That blue is a little richer. I'm going to add some ultramarine blue to it. Make it a little darker in some spots. Okay. So now I'm going to mix a grayish violet with a cloud. I screwed up. Put my brush into the wrong color. Oh, this is palette paper. It's sold at all the art stores, and it's just basically kind of a wax paper. Nice. It comes in a pad. So I'm mixing a violet, but it's a little bit. So the clouds you can be very imaginative with. So this is probably a little too violet, so I'm going to tone it down by adding a little yellow ochre to it, which is what I accidentally did at the beginning. Just a gray, a little gray. And maybe now it's too blue, so I'm going to add a little alizarin crimson. Now it's too red. Actually, it might be perfect. Let me see. That's too strong. That brush off the right there. These clouds are already completely different from when I started. So you just go with them.
Oh, it's all totally different. Okay, so that's enough of that, I think. And now let's do some plain white and kind of work it all together. So I'm just kind of going by memory and instinct right now, because it's all different from when I started. But I have that photograph to access when I go back to rework it. So it ended up a combination of like three things: what I saw at the moment, my improvisation, and then checking the photograph. Stress about clouds, they're kind of fun because you can kind of make them up, right? Or I'm just taking parts of different things I see and being inspired by them. Alright, well, that might be enough for now. Okay, so now, and the other thing that's going to keep happening that I'm going to have to kind of flow with is that the light keeps changing. Now there's no sunlight on the building, so the roof is kind of a dark gray violet again. So it's kind of like the dark part of the cloud, but darker. Take a small brush. Touch this edge up a little bit. Okay. so I'm going to try the chimney. I'll take some burnt sienna, and a little cadmium red, which looks way too bright. So I'll take some alizarin crimson. I'm going to add the gray to it and just dull it down because it's just a little too much. That's way too dark. I'm going to wipe that off. And make it lighter. See, the sun's back and I've got some nice contrast now. I'm going to come back to that. So, some really nice, oh, look at the shadow of the,
I was just seeing that,
of the flag. I don't know if I'm going to put that in. That might just be, I mean, it's cool, but it's a little distracting too. In the shadow of the eaves. So, at this point, windows are just basically little rectangles. angles. I would do normally, I kind of usually work on a painting two sessions, where I try to do a, I would consider this kind of an underpainting, where I get everything set up and then I come back later and a second time to do it in a more finished manner. Okay.
If after we're done here, you want to, you know, in a week or two, send me a final version of it, I can add it to the end of the video.
Cool. Yeah. Probably that's a good idea.
This way people can see your process.
Get a light gray violet, a light one, on this side of the house. Not that happy with this window place, but I'm going to probably change that one. It's a little... Oh, I got to do this too. That should be a bright white there. I gotta change that. Ha! Forgot the windows. Go back and add the windows. those later. Okay, now I'm gonna start painting the stuff around this. This is where I'm going to make up a little bit. I'm going to move things around because I don't like that house there. I didn't want to do that. Some of the white because it's probably I'll just have to repaint that when it's dry. Thank you. And the thing about this time of year is foliage will be a lot different next week than it is now. It'll be gone or a different color. American flags come back for them. This reddish brown I keep going back to. Burnt sienna and some alizarin crimson.
Me how your darker colors make the house pop out like that.
Oh yeah, definitely does. Thank you. It's not gray enough. Some grayish leaves. Stop that for a while. Oh man. I should do this. What should I do first? Into the sky. This is better to do this when the paint is dry, but do it now too. And get all the little gaps between the foliage. Revisit that later too. darker. I think I'm gonna have to do that when it's dry. Yeah, I like that. A little dark. Paint around some of the gravestones. And then go back. Get some of the tree trunks. Gravestones here to worry about. Okay. Well, it's coming along. Like I said, I want to come back another day or for my photograph to tighten it up a little more. All right, so now the lawn. So what time do we have now?
We're just about to hit the next 30-minute mark, so that'll be an hour.
So it's 4:15. might be time to clean off my palate. Or should I just... down color to the green of the yard. It's not too bright. Slab of slate, I might have to put that in later. talking about that purple marker. It's like yellow. It's like a Naples yellow. Naples yellow and violet. Oh, the flags. That might have to go in later. Boxer were like clouds, you know, you don't have to get them exact as long as you get some kind of similarity to what you're...
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. extra special painting because it's a painting from the video. It's like buying a Bob Ross painting.
I'm getting nearly finished for today. I'm getting a little tired. So like I said, at this point I'd probably come back and rework this. Let's see. A little more to do today. A lot of violet. There's kind of a violet thing being repeated here. And that gray of the road. But that might change. So it for today, and then like I said, I'd either try to come back one more time and tighten things up, make the windows a little neater, make those little spots where the canvas is peeking through, get rid of all of that, and finish it. Like probably I'd say another 2 hours work on this and it'll be about done. All right,
so where can people find you?
Where can people find me? The website is ghancin.com, and there's an Instagram, Hancin George. Okay. Email is ghancin@gmail.com. That's okay. Probably the best way. Okay, we're done.
Thank you so much for your time.
Okay, you're welcome.